Hello all, welcome back to the module 5. This is session 3, and in the session 2, that is the previous session, we saw an example or the application of the digital circuit, and in that particular application we saw the sequence detector, and we could come up with designing a sequence detector for a specific sequence using both Mealy as well as the Moore machine. Okay, so based on that, we'll try to form some guidelines for construction of state graphs. Okay, it is not specific, but this is one of the way of approaching any state graph. Okay, so although there is no one specific procedure which can be used to derive state graphs or tables for every problem, the following guidelines should prove helpful. Okay, so that's what I'm saying. These are not the hard and strict rules that you have to follow this only. Okay. So for specific problem, so each problem has its own uniqueness. So that's why there might be some changes. Okay. So in this particular guideline, the first, construct some sample input and output sequence to make sure that you understand the problem statement. Okay. So that's what we did in the example one. Okay. So the very first guideline is construct some sample input and output sequences to make sure that you understand the problem statement. This is one of the first guidelines. Second, determine under what conditions, if any, the circuit should reset to its initial states. Okay, so this is very important. When the circuit should reset to the initial state, when it should not, and that depends upon some conditions. So that's why determine under what conditions, if any, the circuit should reset to its initial state. Then the third guidelines, if only one or two sequences lead to a non-zero output, a good way to start is to construct a partial state graph for those sequences. Okay, so it clearly says if only one or two sequences lead to a non-zero output, a good way to start is to construct a partial state graph. So for any sequence, make sure that you grow from one minimum state graph, that is the partial state graph, then you build on that and finally complete the state graph. Okay, the fourth guidelines being, another way to get started is to determine what sequences or groups of sequences must be remembered by the circuit and set up states accordingly. Okay. So this is another way of approaching. Fifth, each time you add an arrow to the state graph, determine whether it can go to one of the previously defined states or whether a new state must be added. Okay, so that depends upon the what sequence that we have. Then the sixth guidelines is, check your graph to make sure there is one and only one path leaving each state for each combination of values of the input variables. This is very crucial now. Okay, I repeat this guideline. Check your graph to make sure there is one and only one path leaving each state, that is one state, for each combination of values of the input variables. Okay, suppose if I have one input variable, so there will be a state change or a transition is happening from one state to another state for one combination. For another input combination, there is another path. So something like that. The seventh guidelines, when the graph is complete, test it by applying the input sequences formulated in part one, that is the first one, first guideline, and making sure the output sequence are correct. Okay. So these are the some rough guidelines we can follow in order to achieve the building of any sequential circuit or the Moore machine, state machines, what you call. Okay, so with this, we'll go to the second example of application. Again, it will be a sequence detector. Before we go to the next application, we are in the first application. That is, one of the application is a sequence detector can be built either by using a Mealy model or the Moore model. Okay, so the second example in this is a sequential circuit has one input X and one output Z. The circuit examines group of four consecutive inputs and produces an output Z is equal to 1 if the input sequence 0101 or 1001 occurs. Okay, so here the circuit, what we are trying to build or what we have to build, okay, so that circuit output will become 1 or should become 1 either if we encounter the consecutive inputs and if that input is in the input sequence 0101 or if the sequence is 1001. Okay, so either of this is true, the output is 1. Okay, that is the circuit resets after every 4 inputs, meaning after every 4 inputs, either this or any 4 combination of input sequence, the circuit should go to, or circuit should reset. Okay, so and specifically they have given here, find the Mealy state graph. Okay, this is very important now. So if they don't specify which state graph we have to build, okay, so we can build anything. Now in this particular case, he has said, or the problem statement tells us, find the Mealy state graph. Okay, so according to the first guidelines that we framed there, we will specify the input sequence and then when exactly the output becomes 1. Okay, so a typical sequence of inputs and output is X. We are just taking this as one of the sequence. It may be any sequence. Okay. And make sure that this, whatever the vertical line you are seeing, this indicates that the circuit resets after every 4 inputs. Okay. So if I go with the inputs 0, 1, 0, 1, okay, one of the sequence has occurred, so Z is becoming 1 here. After that sequence, not in between the sequence or beginning or whatever, at the end of the sequence, my output should go 1. After this reset, then once again, I come across with 4 bits, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0 here. This is not the sequence that we are detecting. So none at the end of 4 bits, output is not becoming 1. Next, 1, 0, 0, 1. Yes, that is the expected one. So that's why at the end of the 4th, I have 1. Next, 0, 1, 0, 0. Nothing. Okay, so this is just an example we have taken in order to build. Okay, so as I said, the vertical bar indicates the points at which the circuit resets to the initial states. Okay, note that an input sequence of either 0, 1 or 1, 0 followed by 0, 1 will produce an output Z is equal to 1. Okay, so here input sequence 0, 1 or 1, 0 followed by 0, 1. Okay, this is common. Okay, you can see that. In this and in this, 0, 1 is common. Okay. This is what you have to understand the sequences also here. This is our sequence. Okay. You can take any sequence of your own. Okay. So here, note that an input sequence of either 0, 1 or 1, 0, either 0, 1 or 1, 0, followed by 0, 1. This is what? Followed by 0, 1. Okay. Produce an output of Z is equal to 1. Therefore, the circuit can go to the same state if either 0, 1 or 1, 0 is received. The partial. So now we'll try to build the partial state graph and then the complete state graph. Okay. So this is how exactly you have to go ahead after looking into the guidelines and then the example too. We'll move to the next slide. Okay. So here. Okay, so we'll try to build the partial state graph now. Okay, so anyway, we'll try to see how exactly we have come across this. I'll try to draw the same case over here. Okay, so we'll start from the initial state. So again, consider always an initial state. This is the initial state, and that's what I assume now. So my initial state is yes, not. So this is my initial state. In short, I'll be writing, okay? Don't ask me what is exactly, or don't be in a confusion that what is this IS is all about, right? This is an initial state, I am in S naught, okay? Again, my input is what? X. I'll be checking the bit coming with respect to the X, okay? Then, after every 4 bits of input sequence, okay, either my Z becomes 1 or it will remain 0. And when Z becomes 1, either I get 0, 0, 1, 0, 1 as the sequence of inputs or 1, 0, 0, 1. Only at the end of the 4 bits, I get Z is equal to 1. Otherwise, it is 0. Okay. So now, if the very first bit is 0, okay, so that means X is 0. So when I say 0, I'm interested in which two patterns, either 0, 1, 0, 1, or 1001. Okay, I'm interested in this. So meaning the very first out of 4 bits that I get for every 4 bits, okay, if it is 0 or 1, both are interested for me. Yes. Okay, if it is 0, yes. I'm expecting zero. If I get one, that is also expected. So irrespective of whether it is one or zero, you go to the things. So if I get x is equal to zero, make sure that z becomes one only after 4 bits, that too when the sequence 0101 is true or 10012. Otherwise it will be zero. Okay. So when x is zero, output letting zero, this is a mealy, make sure that your output is defined in between the transition. Okay. And it will go to something called S1I com. Okay. Yes. When x is zero, the input, I'm going to next state. Okay. If S is one, also I will go to the next state, disabling still my Z. So you may ask me, sir, irrespective of zero or one, anyhow there is a state transition, but why two different? But I'm interested in the sequence. I am looking into sequence also. If I trace the path from S0 to S1, I'm sure I'm tracing 0101. If I'm going through S0 through S2, then it is 100. Just for our understanding, we are doing that. Okay, so this is what, and this is what is happening at this particular point. Okay, if S0 at S0, if X is equal to zero, go to S1. That's what I have done. If not, X is zero. If it is one, go to S2. Yes, this is what. Then again at S1 and S2, if I am in S2, I will check for X again. If I am in S1, again I will be checked. Okay, suppose if I am in S1, okay, there are two options, either 0 or 1. If my X is 0, okay, you can see that. When I am in S1, I am sure that the one of first bits will be 0. Yes. In S1, if I get X is equal to 0 means, I am interested in this path. If when I am in S1, I'm interested in X is equal to one. The moment I get S is equal to zero, what I have to do? Be in the same state. Be in the same state if you get zero as X with output zero on. Yes. If not, what I will do? If I get instead of zero, X is equal to one means I will go for next state. And which is that next state? I will call it as something like S3. Because S3 is already work. What is the S3? It is 1/0. So now when I say I am in state S1 means I have encountered the first bit as 0. When I say at S3, if I am coming from S1 to S3, then I am sure I have encountered the two bits 0, 1. Yes. S0 to S1 I will move only when X is equal to 0. And I'll move from S1 to S3 only when X is equal to 1. In other words, if I am traversing from S0 till S3, that is 0, 1. Okay. This completes with respect to S1, that with X input. Okay. Now, if I am in S2 rather than being in S1, again, two values, X0, X1. When I'm in S2, I'm sure that the previous X input was 1, right? If that is the case, I'm interested in next bit to be zero in order to move to the next state. Yes. If my next bit is zero, then I have to go to the next state. And I have told, if it is zero, go to the next state and S3 is common. So next state of S2 and next state of S1 is common because 0, 1 or 10 leads to the same state because the next two bits I'll be checking is the common, that is 0, 1. That's why, that's what we have said. The states, next states of S1 and S2 will be remain the same. Okay. So if it is one, I be in the same state. If it is one, be in the same state with output zero. Okay. This is what. Okay. This is again the same thing. So now I am in S3. So from two deviation, again, I come to one. So at S3, again, two possibility, X is equal to zero or one. So now you can see that if I'm coming to S3 from S0, it is 0, 1. If I'm coming from S0 to S2, it will be 1, 0. Okay. So when I'm in S3, it may be a 0, 1 pattern or it may be 1, 0. The sequence received at S3. Okay. Both are same. But after this, you can see that whether it is 01 in the first sequence received or it is 10, the next sequence is 01. That's why the next states of S1 and S2 remains the same. Okay, this is for this particular set of sequence. If you give some other sequence, it may change also. Yeah, that's it. At S3, again, what? Two values. What is that? X0 or 1. Okay. If X is 0, so now, if I'm in S0, I'm encountering the first bit. If either I'm in S1 or S2, I'm encountering the second bit. If I am in the S3, I'll encounter what? The third bit. First here, second in this case, and here I'll be encountering the third. Okay. So if at S3, if I get 0, you can see that whether this pattern or this pattern, I'll move to some other state. I have to move to next state. This is the compulsory. If I receive 0, then I'll go to the next state. Okay. Make sure the arrow is very important. I'll move to the next state S4 with the output still 0. Okay, this is what. What if I get 1, okay? And the problem statement is after 4 bits, I have to reset. After not the 3 bit, that's what. At S0, I'm receiving 1, first bit. Either at S1 and S2, second bit I'm receiving. Here, I'm receiving the third bit. So the problem statement is reset to initial after 4 bits, even whether the pattern is received or not, okay? So if I go from S3 to S4, I've received 3 bits, but I'm in the sequence, okay? Either 010 or 100. If it is 1, I'm moving from S3 to S6, if it is 1, okay? Yes, S6 here, it may be 101 or it may be 100. Okay, the sequence received at S6 is, it may be 101 or 100. Okay, this is. At S6 again, what we have to do? I have to check for X, but it is invalid to, I mean, it's not appropriate to check at S6 because 1010 or 1011 is not the pattern I'm looking. Again, 1000 or 1001 is not the pattern I'm looking. So irrespective of what value of I get for at S6, I'll move to where? I'll move to the initial state S0, whether it is 1 with the output 0 or whether the input is 0 with the output still 0. Okay, that means I have not detected the sequence either 0101 or 1001. So sorry, this is, I'll just erase this. This is 101, sorry. This is 0, okay. This is 0101. This is 101, this is 01. Either of this, I'll go to this. This is of no sequence. But after 4 bit, I have to reset that is there. Okay, so this is what? Okay, this is 1. Yes. Next. Then, this is 1 and this is 0 10. This is S1 is this. Okay. 0 and 1. 0 means, okay. So since there is a resetting thing that we have to do, okay. So there is some slight change in this. Okay. So that means the next state of S1 when X is equal to 0, okay, it will never be here because after this we can't set. Okay, so that's why what we'll do is we'll move from S1 to S5. Okay, when I get 0 with output 0. Okay, because there is a condition that we have to reset, right? That's why. Okay. So again at S5, what we are doing? Again, 0, here it is 0. 00 doesn't give me any pattern. So the next state of S5, I'll just move it to S6. Either it is 1 or 0 of X, I'll move to S6 only. And when I'm in S6, irrespective of X, I'll go to. So S5 and X6 does the same thing. Okay. S5 and S6 are those states wherein we are sure that we can't detect that pattern. The moment I'm in S5 or S6, I'll move to the next state. If I'm in S5, I'll move to the next state, S6. And if I'm in S6, I'll move to the initial set, that is S0. Okay. S4, we have encountered either 0, 1, 0 sequence received, or it is 1, 0, 0. Okay, this is one. So at S4, two things are there. Okay. One, the moment X is equal to 1 or 0. If I get X is equal to 1, means the pattern is achieved. Yes, pattern is achieved. Move to the initial state because 4 bits are over. If it is 1, output is 1. If not, if X is 0, pattern is not recognized. So that's why output is 0. But again, I am going to the initial. So this is what exactly the complete state graph is. And this is what is defined here. We'll try to look into that. Okay. So this is the partial state graph. This is the complete. Okay. So you can see that this is my initial state. We'll look into once again. This is my initial state. Okay, this is my initial state. Yeah. Now, irrespective whether X is 0 or 1, we have to move or have the state change. Okay. So from S0, I will move to S1. Okay. If it is X is 0 or X is equal to 1 by letting output to 0. And that is what we are doing. Okay, so I'll go to S1 when S is 0, or I will go to S2 when X is equal to 1. These two, I'm taking it as a two different paths because I have two different sequence. In both the sequence, I have to determine. Okay, so I'm going to S1 when X is 0, or I'll move to S2 when X is equal to 1. Okay, so output being 0, 0. And if I'm in S1, again, I'll check for 0 or 1. If it is 0, I'll go to S5. If it is 1, I'll go to S3. The only reason why I'm not staying in S1 when it is 0 means because after 4 input sequence, the circuit should reset. So that's why I changed in the previous that the next state of S1 was S1 when the input X was 0, but it is not the case. Okay, so that's why we could change that. Okay, so this is what really happens. S5, if it is 1, go. Okay. So if it is S2, it is nothing but what? 1 is received. If it is S1, it is receiving 0. If I am in S3, either it is receiving 0, 1 or 1, 0. It will receive the sequence received at this point is 0, 1 if I am traversing from S0, S1, S3, or it will be 1, 0 if I am traversing from S0, S2 and S3, something like this. Okay. Then at S1, if it is 0, I'll go to S5 because that is not the sequence. And at S5, irrespective of X 0 or 1, I move to next state. Here, I'm not going to the initial state because the constraints of the problem is after 4 bits only, I have to go to the initial state, reset. Otherwise, I would have resetted from S5 only to go here. Okay, so that is not the case. So that's why this extra state is coming with respect to S6. And as S6, go for it. So at S5, either I'll be receiving 0, 0, or I will be receiving 1, 1. This is 1. This is 1 and this is 1. Either I'll be receiving 0, 0 or 1, 1. This is 1. At S6, either I'll be receiving 0, 0. This is 0. Okay. 0, 0, 0 or 0, 0, 1. Or it may be 1, 1, 1 or 1, 1, 0. So it depends. Okay. This is 1, 2, 3. You can see that 1, 2, 3 or 1, 2, 3. Or if I'm going from S0, S2, S3, S4, it may get 4 also. Okay. So this is what? Okay. This is what? This is with respect to this or this. If I'm coming from S0 to S2, S2 to S4, S4 to this, 1, 2 and 3. So, okay, this is what all. So, if this is the case, it will be 0, 1, 1 or it will be 101. Okay, so you'll get more than. Okay, but all these are doesn't go to the final destination. That is, it doesn't make sure the proper sequence of applicable. And once I get, I'll go here without letting the output one. The moment I'm in S3, it is either 01 or 10. At S3, if I get one, I'll go here because 011 doesn't contribute me for the pattern, or it is 101 doesn't contribute. The moment if it is 0, that means S4 is either 010 or it will be 100, the sequence is 0. At S4, if I get x is equal to 1 means, then initial state S0, okay, once I travels from S0 and when I come back, it is 00101 or it is 1001. If x is equal to 1, let the output 1 go to the initial state. If not, x is equal to 0, sequence is not detected, let the output 0 go to the initial state. Okay, so this is how exactly the complete state graph for the second example, in which either we are detecting 0101 sequence or 1001. Okay, and after every 4 bits, the circuit should become, or the circuit should be reset to the initial state, or it should reset. Okay, and whenever we detect the sequence 0101 or 1001, I should enable the output, and that will happen only when I'm in S4. And from S4, I move to S1, provided S0 when I get one. So we can see here, note that the circuit resets to S0 when the fourth input is. This is one important aspect. Okay, that's why S5 and S6 are additional states, extra states that are there. If this constraint was not there, okay, the moment something is not there, I can immediately go, or I can go from S1 to directly S0, or sometimes S2 to S1. Okay, something like that. Yes, or I can have a reset and be here only, something like that. Yes. So now S0 is the reset or the initial state. You can call the reset as initial state. S1 means it is 0 only. S1 is 0. S2 is 1. This is the sequence received. And S3 is 01 or 10. That's what I have specified already here. S4 is 010100. We have not mentioned S5 and S6 because the moment I'm in S5 and S6, the sequence is not so important. That's why I have not specified here. Okay? Then this same thing here I am specifying. S5, 2 inputs received, no one output is possible. Okay. S6, 3 inputs received, no one output is possible. Okay, so S5, I'm receiving 2 inputs, either one from S1 and S2, but possible outcome cannot be getting. In the same S6, it receives 3 inputs, but again, the possible outcome is not specified. That's why we'll go there. Okay, so based on this, okay, so now there are total how many states? S0 to S6. So S0 to S6. So that is S0, S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. Okay. So if I count, there are total 7 states. 7 means I want to have 3 bits. Okay. So how I encode this as? This is something like 000. This is something like 001. S1 is 1. S2 is 010. With 2 bits, I can't decode all these 7 states. Okay. 7 state means S0 to S6. This is something like 011. This is something like 100. This is something like 101. This is something like 111. Okay, you can have from this you can obtain the state table. Okay, how you will be obtaining the state table? You have a present state from S0 to S6. Then you will get the next state depending upon your x value, right? X is 0, where you will go. X is equal to 1, where you will go. And then you will be finding out the z depending upon your x is equal to 0 or depending upon x is equal to 1. Make sure, since it is a Mealy model, a z output depends not only on the present state but also on the present input. Now depending upon x is equal to 0 or 1, from S0, I will go to S1 when S is equal to 0, or I will go to S2. And I know that when I'm in state 4 and when X is equal to 1, only then my Z becomes 1. In rest all condition, my Z is 0. And you know how to enter from S0 to S6. You just follow. And then if you are designing this using D flip-flop, you require three flip-flops. That is flip-flop A, flip-flop B, flip-flop C. So your 0, 0, 0 means this will be your something like A, B, C. Then find out the next state in terms of A plus, B plus, C plus. Then you obtain the expression for A, B, C. Now there are present state 3, A, B, C, and one input. So you have to use four variable K-map. And whatever the expression you get A plus, that will be the DA input. Whatever the expression you get for B plus, that will be your DB. And whatever the expression you get for C, C plus, that will be for DC. Clock, common clock. Get the expression for Z in terms of X and again the four variable K-map, you'll get. So in this way you can detect. So this is one of the application is the sequence detector. We took two example and we saw how a Mealy can be constructed and how a Moore machine can be constructed for the example one. And for the example two, two different sequences when the output should be one. Okay. So in the next session, we'll take up the another applications. Okay, so thank you.